The year is 1937. The nation, struggling to recover from the Great Depression, finds itself in an economic downturn. Unemployment is once again growing, and soup lines are getting longer. In Europe, fascism is on the rise. The growth of Hitler's power is frightening. In Asia, Japan and China are in combat. The whole world is hurtling toward war. This is a time for Americans to buckle down and dance? From coast to coast, Americans of every age and walk of life are abandoning themselves to the merriment of a new dance craze, the Big Apple. Holding hands like children in friendly circles. They're imitating farm animals. And bringing back the devil-may-care dance moves of the jazz age, the 1920s. The Big Apple was inclusive, a dance that everybody could do. Even in Harlem's Savoy Ballroom, home of the world's greatest dancers, the word was that everybody can do it. But in fact, the Saturday night Big Apple was a performance by some of the most amazing dancers of the day, Whitey's Lindy Hoppers. Whitey himself watches as they perform a version of the Big Apple created by one of his chief dancers, Frankie Manning. The Big Apple dance got its name from the African-American nightclub in Columbia, South Carolina, where the dance craze got its start. The Big Apple building had originally been an Orthodox Jewish synagogue, the House of Peace. When the congregation moved, the building started its new life. Soon, teenagers came night after night to watch the dancers from the balcony of the Big Apple Club. But the great mystery remains. What inspired the young African-American dancers at the Big Apple nightclub to make up this dance? Many scholars agree that the ring shout is the probable root of the Big Apple. In 1937, the Big Apple dance craze lifted the spirits of a depressed nation. Each of its steps had a history which may not have been known to the dancers. Still, when the steps came together into a joyous dance, it had the power to bring people together, to laugh and shout, and feel confident that better times would come.